Now, I think it's important that we take a closer look at work practice, administrative, and engineering controls so that you understand them pretty well. Work practice controls reduce the likelihood of exposure by altering the way in which a task is performed. Now, administrative controls include following all the training, the legal requirements, the policies, and the procedures related to infection control at your facility. While engineering controls isolate or remove the bloodborne pathogen's hazard from the workplace. These include things like sharps disposal containers, needle containment devices, and other safer devices for making sure you don't get poked or cut. Engineering controls shall be examined and or maintained, replaced on a regular schedule to ensure their effectiveness. An example of work practice administrative and engineering controls include the following. Not eating, drinking, smoking, or applying cosmetics or handling contact lenses in work areas where there's a possibility of an exposure to bloodborne pathogens. When emptying trash containers, don't use your hands to compress the trash into the bag. Lift and carry the trash bag away from your body. All equipment and environmental and working surfaces shall be cleaned and decontaminated after contact with blood, body fluids, or other potentially infectious materials. If you're dealing with contaminated needles and other contaminated sharps, they shall not be bent, recapped, or removed. Needles and sharps need to be immediately or as soon as possible after use placed in an appropriate sharps container. Warning labels shall be affixed to the regulated waste and other containers used to store, transport, or ship other potentially infectious materials. These labels shall be fluorescent orange, red, or predominantly so, with lettering and symbols in a contrasting color. Use personal protective equipment. It must be provided by your employer at no cost to you. Examples include gloves. Use them when the potential exists of touching blood, body fluids, or other contaminated items. CPR shields and eye protection. Use these when the likelihood of splashes or secretions of blood or body fluid exists. Gowns. Use them when the potential exists of contact with blood or body fluid on clothing or exposed skin. Masks and respirators. Used to protect from potential airborne infectious diseases. Know where personal protective equipment is at your workplace. Know what personal protective equipment is available and how to use it. Make sure first aid kits and emergency supplies include disposable gloves and CPR face shields or rescue masks. Remember that if you're laundering items such as reusable gowns rather than disposing them, follow your facility's specific procedures for handling laundry. General laundry procedures include wearing personal protective equipment whenever handling the laundry, keeping contaminated laundry separate from other laundry, bagging potentially contaminated laundry where it is used, using leak-proof bags for wet laundry, transporting it in properly labeled bags, especially when shipping contaminated laundry to an off-site facility.